Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Welcome back to the another video of control system MCQs. So the first MCQ is force balancing equation of a mass element where x is equal to displacement is equal to m dx square d square x by dt square m dx by dt mx any of the above. So the correct option will be m dx square by dt. So consider an ideal mass, and let's say this is my ideal mass, and let's say the force applied on this mass is F. And let's say this body apply force, that is, let's say this is F, applied force, and Fm, which is the opposing force due to this mass, okay? And let's say the friction, that is negligible. The elasticity, that is also negligible. Okay, so this is the applied force, this is the opposing force, then the mass will offer an opposing force, okay, which is proportional to the acceleration of the body. So your Fm will be proportional to the t square x by dt. So that should be equal to your Fm will be equal to m d square x by dt square. So this will be the correct option. Okay, next MCQs is, which of the following are the advantage of a closed loop control system? The closed loop are accurate. The closed loop system are less affected by noise, both one and two, neither one and two. So I discuss in detail about the advantage of closed loop control system. And that was, I will repeat again in this video. And that is the, your closed loop system will always be accurate, okay? That will be accurate. Second advantage is that your closed loop system are accurate even in the presence of non-linearities. Third advantage is your closed loop system are less affected by noise. Less affected by noise, okay? It will always be less affected by noise. The last advantage is the sensitivity of the system may be small. Okay, the sensitivity of this system may be small, and due to which the system will always be stable. Okay, your system will be stable. So these are the advantage of closed loop control system. So the closed loop control system are accurate. Yes, that will be accurate. The closed loop system are less affected by noise. Yes, both one and two is the correct option. Okay, next MCQs is force balancing equation of a dash or element is where x is the displacement. So option A is bd square x by dt square bdx dt bx, none of these. So the let's say the let's consider the ideal dashboard, okay? Let's say this is the ideal dashboard element which has a negligible mass and elasticity. So let's say F force is applied on this dashboard. The dashboard will offer opposing force, okay? That is FB, okay? Opposing force. And this opposing force is proportional to the velocity, which is equal to dx by dt. and that will be equal to FB will be equal to capital B dx by dt, where capital B is the constant of proportionality. So the correct option will be option B, B dx by dt. Okay, next MCQ is force balancing equation for elastic element K, where x is equal to the displacement, k d square x by dt square, k d x by dt, k x, none of these. So let's say we take the elastic element, okay? Let's say this is the elastic element, or let's say we take the spring, okay? This is the elastic element. Okay, so if you apply force on this spring, that is F, and if the spring will apply force on you, that is, let's say, Fk. So this Fk will be proportional to the displacement of the load, okay? So this will be proportional to the displacement, and your Fk will be equal to Kx, where K is the constant of proportionality. So option C is the correct answer. Okay, next MCQs is, which of the following are the disadvantages of an open loop control system? Inaccurate, unreliable, both 1 and 2, none of these. So I also discussed in detail about the disadvantage in one of the last video, disadvantage of open loop control system. And that was that the open loop system are inaccurate. Okay, this is inaccurate. Open loop system are unreliable. Open loop, and also the last advantage, disadvantage is the change in the output. Let's say this is the input, this is the output. So any change in the output due to the external disturbance. Due to the external disturbance are not correctly automatically like the closed loop system, okay? So it will not correctly corrected automatically in open loop system. So that is the disadvantage of open loop system. So the correct option will be option C, both 1 and 2. Okay, next MCQs is, which of the following is the analogous quantity for mass element in force voltage analog? So in force voltage analog, let's discuss it in detail. Your mass will be analog to inductor, okay? Your spring constant will analog to 1 by capacitance. Your dashboard, which is represented by B, will be analog to R. Your voltage will be analog to current. Your displacement, which is represented by X, will be analog to charge. Your force will be analog to voltage. So these are the analogs. So in force voltage, the mass will be analog to inductor. So this is the correct option. Okay, next MCQs is, electrical analogous quantity for spring element in force voltage analog is, so in that is 1 by C. So option C is the correct answer. Okay, next MCQs is, in force current analog, electrical analog quantity for displacement. So for in force current analog, your mass will be analog to capacitance. Your spring constant K will be analog to 1 by inductance. Your dashboard B will be analog to 1 by resistance, which is also known as the conductance, which is represented by G. Your velocity will be analog to voltage. Your displacement X will be analog to flux. Your force will be analog to current. So in force current analog, electrical analog quantity for displacement X will be flux. So option D is the correct answer. Okay, next MCQs is the electrical analogous quantity for dashboard in force current analog is resistance. So in force current, the dashboard will be won by R, which is the conductance. So option B is the correct answer. Okay, last MCQs of this video is, if a circuit consists of two mass element, two spring element and four friction element, find the order of the transfer function. So remember, if you want to find the order of the transfer function, so you will only take the mass, okay, count the mass and multiply that by two, so two times number of mass element, so your order will be equal to two times number of mass, and that is two mass element, so two, that's equal to four, so you, it is order four. So option B is the correct answer. So thanks for watching. Allah Hafiz.